We tried to make an FM radio several times before. Finally, with the help of the TDA5767 module, an FM radio was built. In one of the videos, I also used an FM transmitter, and in this video, we want to see how an FM transmitter works. So, be with me to make it. In one of my old videos, I explained that a transmitter needs a high-frequency oscillator. So, first, I will explain how an oscillator is made. The bearing heart of an oscillator consists of an inductor and a capacitor. Now, if we increase and decrease the current passing through the circuit, we can create FM modulation. Well, what can increase and decrease the current inside of this potentiometer? Definitely a transistor. The message signal must be connected to the input of this transistor. To prepare the message signal, forget it. I don't have a good experience with it. You can connect a condenser microphone to a transistor like this and prepare the message signal. While I'm preparing the circuit, please like the video and hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Oh, by the way, the diagram of this circuit is in the description and you can check it out. I know the appearance of the circuit is a bit ugly, but it is working. Let me show you.
Hello world, hello. 1, 2, 3. Don't forget to like this video. And if you haven't subscribed so far, hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, I put the whole circuit on one board because using too much wire increases the noise. I use solder wires as a very large antenna, and I use a 9 volts battery for the power supply. But as you can see, the circuit is extremely unstable and the frequency changes constantly.
Hey, do you read me, sir? 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't forget to like this video. Do you read me?
It is very ridiculous. When I put my hand here, everything works fine.
Hello, sir. Do you read me? 1, 2, 3. Do you read me, sir? Don't forget to like this video. Over.
Okay, our circuit works well sometimes, but it is very unstable. I found a transmitter module that has no name, and it arrived to me after 7 days. Let me open it. Come on, baby. Beautiful. Invoice. These two parts are related to the power supply of the module, which must be connected to the 5 volts Arduino. And these two parts are the I2C interface. Let me write its program and show the result. Well, I searched a bit on the internet and uploaded a program on these two Arduinos. But as you can see here, it doesn't give me any answer. I don't know, maybe my module is broken. Well, all this waiting was apparently useless. But I think that's enough for this video because I have to publish this video today. I will upload more cool videos soon. Be sure to like this video, leave your comments. If you haven't subscribed so far, subscribe. And see you soon. Bye for now.